Good morning everyone. Welcome to Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, situated at Baraipur, 24 PGS, Kolkata, West Bengal, a unit of GIS group. It is a degree and diploma engineering college accredited by AICT, All India Council of Technical Education, affiliated by Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad University of Technology and West Bengal State Council of Technical and Vocational Education Skill Development. It is approved by Government of West Bengal. Our college offers BTech courses like Civil Engineering, Mechanical Engineering, Electrical Engineering, Electronics Communication Engineering and Computer Science Engineering. We also offer diploma courses, Electrical Engineering and Electronics Communication Engineering. So, website of our college www.gkcm.ac.in. Okay, so next move on the course curricula. So, university divided the stream into two parts, Group A and Group B. In the BTech first year, Group A, it is a chemistry based subject. These are the stream, food technology, leather technology, etc. And these are the physics based subject, mechanical engineering, production engineering, civil engineering, etc. Group B, all physics based subject, electrical, electronics based, electrical engineering. Okay. Now, in our college, only electrical engineering and electronics communication engineering will study chemistry 1 in first semester. Okay, so rest of the stream will study physics 1. So this is in the first year, first semester, group B, chemistry 1, BSCH 101, this is the paper code. In the second year, it will be just reverse. Okay, so now this is the course curriculum structure. So basic science course, physics 1, chemistry 1. Okay, so physics 1 will be studied by group B. Group B means in our college only electrical engineering and electronics communication engineering. So total number of contact hours, L means lecture, 3 lectures, T means tutorial 1, T means 0, period. So total credits 4. So these are the other subjects, and you know practical, this is also practical, chemistry BSCH 191, chemistry 1 laboratory. Okay, that will be discussed broadly in lab, whose credit is 1.5. okay, so now come to the marks distributions. As you know, for theory portion there are 100 marks, for practical, chemistry practical, 100 marks. Okay, so now I talk about the marks distributions of theory portion, that is total 100 marks. So out of total 100 marks, as you have seen that internal marks 30 and external exam or external marks is 70. That means internal marks means you have to submit the assignment. Okay, for assignment 10 marks is allotted, for internal examinations, okay, unit test, you can say unit test or class test, 15 marks is allotted, attendance 5. Okay, now external exam, that means you have to appear university exam, okay, whose marks is 70. Now the question will be formed in this pattern, or the these three parts: MCQ question, multiple choice questions, short answer type questions, long answer type questions. So multiple choice questions, there are 10 multiple choice questions, you have to attempt 10, each carry 1 marks. Short answer type questions, 15 marks, you have to attempt 3, each carry 5 marks. Long answer type questions, 45 marks, you have to attempt 3, each question carries 15 marks. Okay, so these are the marks distributions. Again, total chemistry 1 theory 100 marks, out of 100, 30 for internal marks given by the college. That's why you have to submit assignment or quiz etc. for 10 marks. internal examinations, okay, 15 marks, and attendance 5 marks. Total is 30. And out of 70 marks, there will be 3 parts of the question: MCQ portion, short answer type question, long answer type questions. There will be 10 to 12 MCQ questions. You have to attempt 10 MCQ question. Each question can be 1 mark. And short answer type question, total marks 15. You have to attempt 3. Each question carry 1 mark. Long answer type questions, total marks 45. Each question carry 15 marks. Clear? So this is the course curriculum structures of BTech first year of chemistry 1. Okay, next move on the syllabus. Okay, so now you know course code BSCH101/BSCH201. So 1 means here one first semester, 2 means second semester. So BS means basic science. Now course title chemistry 1, you know, credit 4, I have already discussed. Now syllabus. So first, atomic and molecular structure. So these are the broad heading. This is the portion, Schrodinger equation, particle and box solution, etc. That will be taught by DPD. So DPD, short abbreviation of the teacher's name. So DPD means myself, Dr. Deepankar Das. And second portion, spectroscopy technique and application, will be taught by DBM, short abbreviations of Dr. Devayan Mondal, my colleague. And third, intermolecular forces, that will be taught by DPD. Use of free energy in chemical equilibrium, this portion, that will be taught by both DBM and DPD. So from free energy and EMF cell potential to up to this Ellingham diagram will be taught by DPD, and rest of the part will be taught by DBM. Next topic, periodic properties, that will be taught by DPD. Next topic, stereochemistry, that will be also taught by DBM. And last portion, organic reactions and synthesis of drug molecules, that will be taught by DBM. Now these are the reference, learning resource, reference books and some online course, NPTEL, MOOCs, etc. Okay, so university chemistry, B.H. Mahan, chemistry principal applications. So these are the books. So I suggest physical chemistry, P.C. Rokshit, Sarath Bughouse, very important books. These also the another online NPTEL course, okay, by V.L. Temple. So these are the learning resource, reference books and online courses link. Okay, so now next move on the topic. So periodic table. So why I am choosing periodic table first? Because atomic structure is not included in your syllabus. You know, periodic table and atomic structure and chemical bond, these three chapters are backbone of the chemistry, because we have to know the element, we have to know the atomic number, electronic configuration, in which group, in which period, situated in the periodic table, what are the electronic configurations, so how to write the electronic configurations. So all are depends on the periodic table. So that's why first of all I have to study periodic table, because we have to study periodic table. Periodic table tells about details of the element, not only element, all the elements belong to the same group. So that's why we are going to discuss first periodic table. Okay, so before going to periodic, modern periodic table, we should know the history of periodic table. You know, periodic table, there are so many hypotheses, Proust, Dovenier, Lothar. This will not come in the exam, but we should know the history of the periodic table before going through the modern periodic table. What is the periodic table? Introductions. Periodic table help us to undergo systematic study of the various elements found in nature, without which it would have been impossible for us to study all elements. By classifying the elements into various groups and periods, comparative study of elements and their compounds can be done. It also helps us to analyze periodic trend in various properties such as ionization potential, electron affinity, electron negativity, melting point, boiling point, lattice energy, density. So many properties can be known from this periodic table. So need of classification of element, what is the necessity behind this? Why are you doing this? A large number of elements had been discovered, from 31 elements to 118 elements till date. So out of 118 elements, 92 elements are naturally occurring and remaining are man-made. It is very tough to go through each and every element accurately and their compounds. So it is required to systematize and arrange a definite order according to their properties. Next, development of classification of elements. There are so many hypotheses which were developed one by one. First one is Prout's hypothesis. What he said? He said that all the elements are made up of hydrogen. So we can tell that atomic weight of element equals to n into atomic weight of one hydrogen atom. Or atomic weight of hydrogen equals to 1, where n equals to 1, 2, 3. But he has also limitations. Limitation, every element cannot be formed by hydrogen. Atomic weight of elements were not found as a whole number. As for example, chlorine atomic weight 35.5, strontium atomic weight 87.5. Okay, so this is the drawbacks of the Prout's hypothesis. Next, another hypothesis, Dovinier triad rules. ZW Dovinier pointed out that within a group of three elements having similar chemical and physical properties, the atomic weight of middle element, is the mean of other two. Some examples of triads are given here. Lithium, sodium, potassium, same group. Calcium, strontium, barium, same group. Sulfur, selenium, tellurium, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Atomic weight, lithium 7, sodium 23, potassium 39, calcium 40, strontium 88, barium 137, sulfur 32, selenium 80, tellurium 128, chlorine 30.5, bromine 80, iodine 127. If you get the mean value, we get mean value, you see 23. Okay. 40, 88, 137, 48.5, 32, 80, 128, 80, 35.5, 80, 128, 81.25. Other examples, potassium, rubidium, cesium, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, scandium, yttrium, lanthanum. Okay, so lanthanide. Though it was the first successful attempt to rationalize the problem, it could not be generalized or extended. So that's why, again, limitation comes. All known elements could not be arranged as triads, only to limited number of elements. So another hypothesis, Newland-Octave law, which was proposed that chemical properties of the elements with their atomic weight, known as law of octaves. Means John Alexander Newland in England made the first attempt to correlate chemical properties of the elements with their atomic weight, known as law of octaves. According to him, if the elements are arranged in order to their increasing atomic weight, every eight element had similar properties of first one, like the first and eighth note in music. Lithium, sodium, beryllium, magnesium, boron, aluminium, carbon, silicon, nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen, sulfur, fluorine, chlorine. What will happen? First and eighth. Sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Clear? So element, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, chlorine. Atomic weight 7, 9, 11, 12, 14, 16, 19. Elements sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. Atomic weight 23, 24, 27, 29, 31, 32, 30.5. Element potassium 39, calcium 40. So this is the Newland octave law. Inert gases were not discovered till then. All the elements could not be classified on this basis. So again, drawbacks observed. The system applied for only lighter elements up to calcium and failed to heavier elements. So this hypothesis or this law, Newland octave law, applicable for calcium, that is up to calcium means lighter element, it is not applicable for heavier elements. Next, another hypothesis, Lothar Meyer curve. So he proposed that physical properties of the element are the periodic function of their atomic weight. Keep in mind, physical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic weight, and this become the base of Mendeleev's periodic table. This become the base of Mendeleev's periodic table. He plotted a graph between atomic weight and atomic volume of the element. The following observation can be made as most electropositive element like alkali metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium occupy the peak position on the curve. Here you see potassium, rubidium occupy the peak positions. So most electropositive metals or elements occupy the peak position of the curve, and less electropositive, that is alkali earth metal, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium occupy the descending position on the curve. If you look, okay, you see this is the position, okay, magnesium, okay. So now, and metalloids arsenic and astatine and transition metal occupy the bottom part of the curve. Metalloids and transition metal occupy the bottom part of the, again go to this, okay, transition element, and this is the metalloids occupying the bottom, okay. Now Mendeleev periodic table, Mendeleev's periodic law. The physical and chemical properties of elements, are the periodic function of their atomic weight. Physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic weight. This is the Mendeleev periodic table law based on atomic weight, not atomic number. So here there are up to 8 groups. So group 1 can be divided subgroup A and B. So this is the group 8 transition series. So this is the Mendeleev periodic table based on atomic weight. Now characteristics of Mendeleev periodic tables. So what are the tenets? The 63 elements were known. Noble gases were not discovered. He was the first scientist to classify the elements in a systematic manner. He was the first scientist to classify the elements in a systematic manner, that is, horizontal rows and vertical columns. Horizontal rows are called periods, and there are 7 periods in the periodic table. Vertical columns are called groups. There are 8 groups in the periodic table. If you look, this is the 8 group. So this is the vertical. This one the vertical. These are the horizontal. This one horizontal. This one vertical. Okay. Each group up to 7A is divided into A and B subgroup. A subgroup elements are called normal elements, and B subgroup elements are called transition elements. Elements belonging to the same group exhibit similar properties. So according to him, if the elements belong to the same group, 2 or 3 elements, they show the same physical properties or exhibit same physical properties, also chemical properties some. Clear? So these are the characteristics or tenets or postulates of Mendeleev periodic table. What are the merits, advantage? The first time all known elements were classified in groups. According to their similar properties. It gave encouragement to the discovery of new elements as some gap was left in it. If some new element can be discovered later or in future, that's why he left some space or gap. Scandium, gallium, germanium, technetium. Blank space at atomic weight 72 in silicon groups was called eka silicon, means properties like silicon. Eka means properties like silicon. And elements discovered later was named germanium. Now Mendeleev periodic for the element eka aluminium or gallium, eka silicon for germanium. So first property, what are the property? Atomic weight, density gram per cc, melting point in Kelvin, formula of oxide, formula of chloride. Eka aluminium predicted, what are the found? What was found? Gallium found. Eka silicon predicted. What element found? Germanium. So atomic weight, eka aluminium 68 predicted. Gallium found 70. Silicon 72, 70.6. Density 5.9, 5.94, 5.5, 5.36. Melting point low. 29.78, high 1231, formula of oxide E2O3, that type of oxide form, Ga2O3, EO2, GeO2, formula of chloride ECl3, GaCl2, ECl4, GeCl4. And one correction was done in atomic weight of some element like uranium, beryllium, aurium, that is gold, and platinum. What correction? The correction was atomic weight equals to valency into equivalent weight. So atomic weight equals to valency into equivalent weight. So now similarly, like other hypothesis, there is also defect. There are defects of Mendeleev periodic table. What are the defects? Position of hydrogen is uncertain. Why? Because it has been placed in group 1 and group 7 because of its resembles or similarities with both the groups. Position of hydrogen is uncertain. It has been placed in group 1A and group 7A because of its resemblance with both the group. No separate position was given to isotope. No separate position was given to isotopes. It is not clear whether the lanthanides and actinides are related to second group A and second group B. It is not clear whether the lanthanides and actinides are related to second group A and second group B. Order of increasing atomic weight is not strictly followed. Order of increasing atomic weight is not strictly followed in the arrangement of elements in the periodic table, as for example argon 39.9 before potassium, whose atomic weight 39. So order of increasing atomic weight is not strictly followed in the arrangement of elements in the periodic table, argon 39.9 before potassium 39. Although there is no resemblance except valency of subgroup A and B, they have been put in the same group. Now we come to the our topic, modern periodic table. Why? Because modern periodic table, we explain everything, we justify everything on the basis of this modern periodic table, because we have to know all the physical chemical properties like ionization enthalpy, electron affinity, electron negativity, ionic size, ionic radius, electron boiling point, melting point, density, whatever. We have to know the position of the element first. First, what, how many groups, how many periods are present in the modern periodic table, and how many columns, that is group, how many periods present, and in which group and which period element is situated, what is the atomic number, what is the electronic configurations. So you should know everything, then you can explain any classification or properties, etc. So modern periodic table is very important. Now from this portion question will come, there are a lot of questions will come, so this is the very important topic. So now look at this periodic table. So modern periodic table consists of, as I told, 18 vertical columns. What are the one columns? Group 1 starting from lithium, okay, also hydrogen lithium. Group 2 starting from beryllium. Group 3 scandium. Group 4 titanium. Group 5 vanadium. Group 6 chromium. Group 7 manganese. Group 8 iron. Group 9 cobalt. Group 10 nickel. Group 11 copper. Group 12 zinc. And group 13 boron. Group 14 carbon. Group 15 nitrogen. Group 16 oxygen. Group 17 fluorine. Group 18 helium. Okay, so these are the 18 vertical columns or groups. Now this is the period on hydrogen, helium. Second period starting lithium to neon. Third period sodium to argon. Fourth period potassium to krypton. Fifth period rubidium to xenon. Sixth period cesium to radon. Seventh period francium. Okay, so now group 1 and group 2, this group 1 and group 2 is called S block element. Later we will discuss what are the S block, P block, D block and A block. And group 3 to 12, this is called transition element. And group 13 to group 18, it is called P block elements or representative elements. And we know group 18 is called noble gases and group 17 is halogen. Okay, now inert transition elements, here in group 3, lanthanide and actinide. So lanthanide starting from cerium to lutetium and actinide thorium to laurentium. Okay, so these are the modern periodic table. You know, atomic number hydrogen 1, helium 2, lithium 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the atomic number 7, 8, 9, 10. As you know, electronic configuration, okay, 1s1, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, 2s2, 2p2, sorry, 1s1, sorry, 2s2, 2s1, okay, 1s2, 2s2, here 2s, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, why here writing 2s2, 2p1, because this is the valence cell. Higher number of n, principal quantum number n equals to 2. So in this principal quantum number n equals to 2, how many orbital, suborbital, s and p? So s contains 2 electrons, p contains 1 electrons. So that's why it is valence, valence electron is 3. So that's why it is called 13 group. Okay. Now 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So this is the electronic configuration. Now if you see oxygen atomic number 8, sulfur it will be 8 plus 8 16, that will be discussed later how to remember this atomic number of a same group element. So again I tell you, this is the modern periodic table, consists of 18 vertical columns as I discussed, and along with 7 periods. Group 1 and group 2 is called S block element, and group 13 to group 18 called P block element, representative element. So group 18 is called noble gas element, group 17 halogen, and group 3 to group 12 is called transition element. In this element also there is an inner transition element, a block, lanthanide and actinide series. Okay, so now modern periodic law. What are the modern periodic law? Modern periodic table law is the physical and chemical properties. Physical and chemical properties of elements are the periodic function of their atomic number. Physical and chemical properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic number. So in the previous earlier case, earlier Mendeleev periodic law, what he said, the physical and chemical property is the function of atomic weight. But in modern periodic table, it is the physical and chemical property and the function of atomic number. So this modern periodic table based on atomic number, not atomic weight. So now characteristics. Let's see what are the characteristics of modern periodic table. According to Moseley, did an experiment in which he bombarded high speed electron on different metal surface and obtained X-rays. He found out that root nu proportional to z, where nu equals to frequency of x-ray and z equals to atomic number. According to him, 9 vertical columns called groups, inert gases were introduced in periodic table by Ramsey, 7 horizontal series called periods. Now come to the very important, as in the earlier I have shown that modern periodic table, that is the long form of modern periodic table. Look this, this is the long form of the periodic table. Okay, it is also called Bohr-Bury-Rank and Wörner periodic table. It is also called Bohr-Bury-Rank and Wörner periodic table. This is called long form of periodic table. Again I look, this is the long form of periodic table. Okay, it is based on, this is the very important, the characteristics of long form of periodic table. It is based on the Bohr-Bury electronic configuration. It is based on Bohr-Bury electronic configuration concept and atomic number. This model is proposed by Rank and Wörner. 7 periods and 18 vertical columns. 7 periods and 18 vertical columns proposed by Rank and Wörner. According to IUPAC, 18 vertical columns are named as group 1 to 18th as a group. So 18 vertical columns are named as a group, or you can say column. Elements belong to the same group, having same number of electron in the outermost shell. Now look this, this is the very important, all the points are very important. As I told earlier, elements belong to the same group, having the same number of electron in the outermost shell. Outermost shell means valence shell. How many electron present in the valence shell or outer shell, that is called valence electron. So elements having the same group possess same number of valence electron. Okay, and also their property is almost same. Again, I recap these characteristics of long form of modern periodic table. It is based on Bohr-Bure electronic configuration, consists of 18 vertical columns and 7 periods. Elements belong to the same group, having same number of valence electrons, and also show the same properties. Okay. Now modern periodic table, description of periods. You know, periods 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, n means, you know, principal quantum number in atomic structure. We have gone through 4 quantum numbers, what? Principal quantum numbers, n, azimuthal quantum numbers, small n, magnetic quantum numbers, small n, and spin quantum numbers, small s. So there are 4 quantum numbers. So n equals to here, principal quantum number, n equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here subshell 1s, 2s, 2p, for second period 2s, 2p, third period 3s, 3p, fourth period 4s, 3d, 4p, fifth period 5s, 4d, 5p, sixth period n equals to 6, 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p, and 7s, 5f, 6d. So number of elements 2. Again I recap, this is the period, this is the n means principal quantum number, n 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Subshell 1s for 2, 2s, 2p, 3, 3s, 3p, 4, 4s, 3d, 4p, 5, 5s, 4d, 5p, 6, 6x, 4f, 5d, 6p, 7, 7s, 5f, 6d. So how many elements present in the subshell for 1s, 2, 2s, 2p, 8, 3s, 3p, 2 plus 6, 8, 4s, 3d, 4p, 2, plus 10, plus 6, 18, d contain maximum 10 electrons, p6, 4, 2, 5s, 4d, 5p, 18, 6x, 2, 4f, 14, 5d, 10, 6, p6. So 6 plus 10 plus 14 plus 6, 32, 7s, 5, 8, 6d, 26. So these are the number of elements. Elements 1, H1, helium, H2, name of the period, shortest, short, lithium, sodium, long, and longest, incomplete. Okay. So these are the description of the period according to principal quantum numbers and subshell. So what are the important points? The first one is diagonal relationship. We have gone through in class 12 level, diagonal relationship. Second period elements, lithium, beryllium, magnesium, shows diagonal relationship. If you look, second period, this is the second period, okay, beryllium, magnesium, okay. Lithium, beryllium, magnesium, you see, this is the second, lithium, beryllium, okay. Lithium, beryllium, boron, with third period, magnesium, aluminium, silicon. So lithium, beryllium, boron, again see, lithium, beryllium, boron, okay, magnesium, aluminium, sodium, okay. So lithium, magnesium, beryllium, aluminium, boron, silicon. So lithium diagonal relationship, magnesium, beryllium diagonal relationship, aluminium, boron diagonal relationship with silicon. Now bridge element. The typical elements D, third period, are also called bridge elements. as the division between two subgroups A and B start from these elements. In second group, magnesium acts as a bridge element. The properties of bridge elements are some hot mixed properties of the elements of two subgroups, as magnesium shows similarities with alkaline earth metals group 2 on one hand, with zinc metals group 12 on the other. Second and third period elements, except inert gas element, are called typical elements because they represent the properties of other elements of their respective group. Atomic number of last inert gas element is 86. Number of gaseous elements 11. So these are the characteristics of long period modern periodic table. So atomic number of last inert gas 86, number of gaseous elements 11, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, plus noble gases. Number of liquid elements 6, cesium, francium, gallium, mercury, bromine, and this EUB. Bromine is only the non-metals which exist in liquid form. So bromine is the only non-metal which exist in liquid form. Number of solid elements 95, if discovered elements are 112. Second periodic contents, maximum number of gaseous elements, they are 4, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon. So second period contents, maximum number of gaseous elements 4, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Again I recap, so these are the main component or main features of this long modern periodic tables. Second period contents 4 gaseous elements, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Okay, number of solid elements 95 if we consider up to 1 on 2 discovered of elements. Number of liquid elements 6, cesium, francium, gallium, mercury, bromine, and EUB. Number of gaseous elements 11. Okay, so these are the features of the long modern periodic table. Now this is the IP nomenclature. Okay, this is very less important in respect to BTEC students. So IP gave names to elements of atomic number. If for those students who are interested, get a for a reference knowledge. 0 for nil, 1 for an, 2 for bi, 3 for tri, 4 for quad, 5 for pent, 6 for hex, 7 for sept, 8 for oct, 9 for en. In all the elements, suffix is ium, 101, an, nil, unium, symbol enu. IPEC official name, mendelevium, IPEC symbol this. 102, an, nil, bium. So this UNB, 103, UNNIL, TM, UNT. So these are the IPEC nomenclature of the elements. Now electronic configuration of group 1 alkali metals. Electronic configuration of group 1 alkali metals. Atomic number, column, first column atomic number, symbol, electronic configurations. Why I am discussing this? Because as atomic structure is not included in your syllabus, this portion already discussed in atomic structure. But for those students who didn't know or forget to how to write the electronic configurations, they should know the atomic number 3, a symbol lithium, we should write 1s2 2s1, or you can write helium within third bracket 2s1. Why? So how many electron? 2 plus 1 3. So in case of atomic number 11, symbol sodium, how to write electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Or you can write neon. Why neon? Because neon atomic number is 10. So 10, neon, 3s1. 19, a symbol potassium, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. Or argon, because atomic number of argon is 18, so 18 plus 1, that is 19, so argon 4s1. 37, rubidium, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 5s1, or you can write krypton 36, 5s1. Similarly, 55, cesium, xenon 6s1, 87, francium, radon 7s1. So these are the electronic configuration of particular atomic number with symbols. So how to write the electronic configuration of particular elements? Now, division of elements into SPDA block and their characteristics. This one also important. As I have seen that in the modern periodic table, long form of periodic table, there are four blocks: S block, P block, D block, and A block. S means alkaline hard metals, P block representative elements, non-metals portions, and metalloids and metals, and D block transition elements, and also in a transition element, A block. According to above principle and the electronic configuration of atoms provided a foundation for the periodic classification, the vertical columns known as group or family show similar properties due to the same number of valence electron. The type of atomic orbitals classify the different blocks: S block, P block, D block, A block. There are two exceptions. One is helium, which belongs to S block but placed in P block in the noble gas group, that is 18th group. It is because of completely filled valence shell. Other exception is of hydrogen, which shows the properties of metal by showing the tendency to donate electron, whereas it also shows the property of non-metal by accepting one electron in order to attain noble gas configuration like that of helium. So being treated as a special case, it had been placed at the top of the periodic table. So why? What I am telling you, again we go to or move to periodic table. You see, actually hydrogen will be placed here. Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, and helium already placed here. Okay. So again I recap, according to Auffa principle, the modern periodic table can be classified four blocks, S block, P block, and D blocks. There are two exceptions: one case of helium, which belongs to S block but placed in a P block in the noble gas group. Okay. And in case of hydrogen, it is also placed in the group 1 alkali metals groups, although we shows the property of metal by showing tendency the donor electron, and it also show the property of non-metal by accepting the one electron in order to attain noble gas configuration like that of helium. So being treated as a special case, it had been placed at top of the periodic table. So again I tell you, hydrogen in the group first group, helium in the 18 group elements. So hydrogen in group 1 and helium is group 18. So these are the periodic tables, group 18, total number of groups 18 or 18 columns, 7 periods. And how to write the electronic configuration? This one, the electronic configuration, higher number of the principal quantum number value. From this we get the number of valence electron present in the particular elements. In the next class we will discuss how to find out group number, period number, and valency. Okay. And details of the S block, P block, P block, D block, and A block. So details, characteristics of S block, P block, and D block, and A block. Okay, how to write the electronic configurations, and what are the their representation, how to represent S block, P block, D block, and A block. So remember, go through this chapter, go through this all. Okay, and watch this video lecture. This is very interesting. Video lectures, we enjoy it. And if you have any problem, okay, you can contact with me, there will be no problem. So thank you all for listening or watching this video lecture of periodic table first lecture, video lecture. Okay, again I just before ending this video lectures, I tell you that you should go through the from modern periodic tables. If you wish to know the history of the periodic table, then you can go through, but from your, according to your syllabus, the question will come from long modern periodic table. Okay, so we go through the modern, long modern periodic tables, their characteristics, their classifications, their number of periods, number of columns, how to write the electronic configurations, and what are the, how many types of blocks present: S block, P block, D block, A block. So that should be known to everyone, because if you discuss or justify or explain any elements, we should know the first atomic number of the element, we should know the position of the element in modern periodic table, we should know the how to write the electronic configuration. So if you know the atomic number of one element, you can find out the atomic number of other element. We can explain the almost same properties, physical or chemical, of the other elements belong to the same group. So thank you all for watching this video. I hope you enjoy this video.